seeing the first Indiana Jones movie, Raiders of the Lost Ark, when I was probably around 10, I guess. I went with my dad to see it at the theater, and it totally blew my mind. I was completely hooked when I saw that movie. It was just so cool. And when I came home, I remember searching through my grandfather's closet for one of his old-time hats and trying to figure out a way I could get my hands on a bullwhip so I could, like, play it outside. Later that year, when I went to visit my mom in the summer, because my parents were divorced by then, when she'd go to work, she worked, she had her own, like, beauty salon, and so I didn't much like hanging out there during the day, so she'd give me, I guess probably $5 or something to go see a movie and to walk down to the theater that was kind of close by there, so I'd go down there. I'd get a ticket for a movie. And I don't remember how much movies were back then, but I was able to get, you know, a ticket for a movie, popcorn, and a drink, and then still have enough to stop by and get some comics on the way back to her shop after I was after I was done with that $5. But anyway, I'd go in and I'd buy a ticket to the first movie, and then I'd watch like 3 movies in a row. Like, once one movie was about done, I would, like, sneak across the hall and go into another movie that was already going. So I remember that summer and, you know, the next few summers where I was there visiting her, I just saw, like, every movie that came out. And I would see them, like, over and over again. So, like, even the bad movies I would kind of gain an appreciation for. I remember one of those summers was also the year Alien came out, and I was scared to go see that one. But then finally, thought I'd chance it. I'd sneak into Alien. You know, of course, that one was R-rated, so I wasn't supposed to be in there anyway. That movie scared the absolute daylights out of me. I remember not going back and watching it again. But I think that summer, you know, those summers, like spending those summers with my mom and going to the movies like so often, you know, they kind of woke up a love for, like, storytelling, I think, you know, movies and comics, because, like I said, I would stop by this little, I don't know what it was, kind of almost like a Spencer's or something. They had, like, magic tricks, they had some comics, they had posters, and I would, you know, look around and I'd buy something out of there, you know, usually comics, but I remember also finding, like, the first Frank Frazetta posters I'd ever seen in there, bringing those back, and my mom got mad at me, told me I had to take them back, and I argued with her, and got to keep them. I think all that stuff kind of set me on the early path to eventually become an artist and have such an interest in this stuff. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I wanted to cut this video together with the Temple of Doom soundtrack, and I wanted to have some clips of the movie in there. But when I looked it up on YouTube, you know, all the Indiana Jones music is, you know, banned in like 246 countries or something like that. So YouTube would have just knocked it back down anyway. So I decided to go a different direction. Don't forget to sign up for the mailing list underneath the video if you guys want to get notifications every time a new video comes out. Check me out on Patreon if you guys would like to see some extended cuts of these videos. I'm trying to do like 30-minute long videos with extra commentary and that kind of stuff. I'll see you guys next time.